Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Living a Life Show. I'm your host, Columbus Cody. And today I'm sitting in the line to get my new tags. They expired 3 days ago, but don't tell nobody. All right, I forgot my car was in the shop. It expired in March. Here we are, April 2nd, and I got to get new tags. And speaking of newness, let's talk about yesterday. Yesterday was Easter. Yesterday, I saw a lot of people looking really good. I mean, like, really good. They were sharp. The suits were just boom, banging. The dresses was on point. Everybody looked good, and it was a wonderful sight. And then it made me think back to how I once was. See, yesterday, it dawned on me when I got dressed for church. God showed me this, that I was wearing a suit that I've owned for about 12 years. I was wearing shoes that I've owned for about 15 years. I was wearing a shirt that I bought from Goodwill for $4.97. The newest things I had owned was a tie and socks that I may have bought 2 years ago. And I thought about how I used to be. I used to be that guy that would say, I can't go to church because I don't have any church clothes. You guys have probably heard people say stuff like that. Maybe you've even been that person that said things like that. But I thank God that He has elevated my mindset to understand it's not about the clothes. If you take off my suit, and it wasn't an expensive suit, but if you take off my suit, and even if it was an Armani suit, the suit doesn't matter. The socks don't matter. The shirt doesn't matter. The tie doesn't matter. It matters what's beneath the suit. It matters what's in my heart. God is looking at our heart, not at our tags on our clothes. So I thank God that He's elevated my mindset about that. But thinking about newness, getting these new tags. Yesterday, we celebrated and we honored Jesus for dying on the cross for us, but not just dying, for raising from the grave. And the newness of life that we have because of what He did for us is something we can never take for granted. So here's my question to you. Now that Easter is over, yesterday was Easter, Easter is past. Now that it's over, what will you do with Jesus now? Do you pack Him back up and put Him back in the tomb to bring Him out again next year? Or do you allow Him to lead your life today, tomorrow, the next day? Because what it boils down to is this. You have to renew your relationship with Christ daily. When He opens your eyes, He gives you a new day to live a new way. Not to live your old way, not to keep walking in old things, but to become a new creature. So I thank God that He's made my mind new. And I vow and I promise Him that every day He opens my eyes, I will try to live even more better for Him. Is that correct? More better? You get what I'm saying. So, what are you going to do with Jesus now that Easter is over? I think that's a good question. I think that's a valid question. I think that's a question maybe you should take a moment and truthfully answer. What will you do with Jesus now that Easter is over? See, because when He died on that cross and He rose from that grave, He gave us the power to live a life that we once weren't able to live. You are now capable of living a life that pleases God, because when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, God places within you His Spirit. His Spirit desires to do His things. And so if you have a desire to do God's things, but you're still falling short, it's because we're not leaning on His Spirit to guide us. We're allowing His Spirit to speak, but we're choosing to disobey the Spirit and do what we want. His Spirit will speak. His Spirit will guide. His Spirit will show you the way. It just boils down to how badly do you want to please God versus please yourself. So, and when I say you, I'm talking about me too. So don't feel like I'm saying something judgmental to you, like I've arrived, like I got it all perfect, because I don't. I'm just striving every day to perfect what God has placed within me. I'm trying every day to rest in Him, to put my hands in His hands and allow Him to guide me, allow Him to march me through this life. And He has shown Himself faithful. In all the years that I've served God, He has shown Himself faithful. So if you're watching this video and you actually don't have a connection with God, you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I beg you, I beseech you, I humbly ask you right now, just take a moment when this video ends and just ask Jesus into your heart. Just say it. Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I want you. I recognize my life is in shambles. I recognize that maybe my life is not in shambles, but there's still something missing. And I recognize it's you. I recognize that I don't have a connection with you. Or maybe that guy that keeps going to church, but you really don't know God yet. I mean, like, I have perfect attendance at church. I don't miss church. I just don't feel that connection yet. Ask him to connect with you. Ask him to guide you. Ask him to lead you. Ask him to be your Lord and Savior. And if you do that, if you ask him right now, just say, Jesus, please be my Lord, be my Savior. I don't want to guide my life anymore. I don't want to live without you anymore. He will enter your heart immediately, and he will give you the life that you truly want to have. He will give you an abundant life. See, the life that God requires, Jesus died to make that possible. So it's possible for you and I to live the life. So thanks again for joining me today. If you have a quick moment, push the like button down below. Also, if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe to the channel. My goal is to hit 1,000 subscribers by, let's shoot for May 31st. It's April the 2nd, May 31st. That gives me about 2 months. I'm about 200 short. So that means I need 200 of y'all to push the subscribe button. It takes about 2 seconds to push, and you'll be glad you did, because you won't miss any of these videos when they come out. So God bless you, and remember, Easter's over, but your relationship with God does not have to go back on the shelf. God bless.